And so we are going to go now to Jamie's craft talk. So Jamie, are you ready? I will stop sharing so that you can share.
I've never shared before, so let me see if I know how to do this.
Wait a minute. Wait, I can't find my mouse has gone crazy. There we are. Okay.
Okay, so let's see here. Okay.
There you go. You're on it.
Okay. Well, thank you everyone for giving me a chance to talk a little bit about myself. That's what everyone likes to do. I'm just so glad to be a part of this group, going through the process and looking at other groups. We just stand so far above the rest. So it's wonderful to be a part of this. I've recently moved back, I wanted to kind of center this talk around Humboldt County and my ties here. So you can see here, I was born in Fortuna. My birth date's 4567. My dad was Jim Anderson. He was a CPA at Rodrigue Anderson and Summer. Working marriage therapist in Fortuna at the age of 86. So wonderful woman. My sisters, I have two sisters, Leslie Ziegler, he's 7 years older than me. She's married to Paul Ziegler, who works at Eureka City Schools, if you've ever run into him. And then I have another sister down in Novato. Here you can see kind of the mod squad picture over here of the family. So background, went to Fortuna Union High School, graduated in 85. I'm sure you can see the brooding blonde-haired guy in the back with the big head of hair. That would be me on the Fortuna High soccer team. So graduated in 85, played lots of soccer. I played year-round soccer, played basketball. Unfortunately, Arcata was our biggest foe, and they were always better than us, so that was a little troubling. But played lots of sports, basketball, BMX. Once I graduated from high school, a buddy of mine from school and I decided let's apply for Davis. We got in, so I went there as an econ and statistics major. Quickly learned that I did not like statistics, so I changed my degree to organizational studies. I was a management major in the sociology department, and for a career in management that I went into, it certainly became a good major overall. So when I said I wanted to do my talk around Humboldt, one of the things that kind of draws us back is our family cabin out at Denny. I don't know if any of you have ever know where that is. It's basically past Willow Creek, head to Trinity Village, and then up and over the hill for 20 miles. And you get to a little valley on the New River. So pretty, a lot of gold miners, probably some cannabis growers out there, but we've had that cabin for such a long time, and it's such a wonderful part of our family. You can see this picture on the left. There are four cabins across the river, so to get to the cabins, you have to get on a gas-powered tram. The cable is about 150 yards long and probably about 100 feet down to the river. So not for the faint of heart, but once you get there, it's beautiful. All you do is eat, drink, sleep, swim, repeat. No cell phone coverage. So you can see the picture on the right is the river. So just beautiful and something that really draws us back from other times. I would be lost without my wife of 25 years. We've been together for 28, Suzette. We were celebrating our 25th anniversary this September, and unfortunately a trip to Europe turned into a really nice bottle of wine and steak at home during COVID, but we'll get out there eventually. I thank you. I think I did buy the Plaza Grill gift card for that, so thank you, Tom. But here's Suzette at the cabin. I think that's a Pirate Fest picture from a couple years ago. And then there we are in Portland. We've been empty nesters for quite some time. So a lot of this stuff, I struggle to find recent pictures of our kids since we moved. But talking about hobbies, I love to fish. I thought I'd put this one up there because this is one of my wife's favorite stories. This was a trip to Cancun. And I will say, first fish on was the one on the right. I was a gentleman. I let my wife take the rod first. That's what she landed with a little bit of help. This was, of course, my first fish. So I do like fishing. You know, I'm a big steelhead fisherman, so I enjoy that. Probably my biggest passion is cycling. I've done that since an early age. The picture you see on the left was when I was in Denver. I would do a ride called the Triple Bypass. It was 120 miles, one day. You'd start at 7,000 feet, climb up to 12,000 feet. You know, you'd do, I think, 11,000 feet of climbing. So that was quite a ride. The one there in the middle is from Boise to McCall. That was an actual race. So one of my biggest passions, I do mountain bike as well, but road biking is kind of what I like to do. And yeah, I do have two kids. So as I said, they've been out of the house for a while, but our son Brandon on the left has just moved back here. He's always wanted to be here. We always told him, yeah, no. But since we actually ended up moving back home to be closer to family, we said, well, why don't you come on out? So he's just recently moved out and starting a new career. On the right is our daughter, Stephanie. She still lives in Denver. We see her, you know, once, twice a year. These are our real kids, though. You know, again, these are the ones, if you check my phone camera roll, you'd see mostly pictures of these. So this is BB, our little Frenchie puppy, or as we call her, the Bebinator. There's Jesse, our cat, and then my dog, Sadie Sue, a charcoal lab. So she is my love. But yeah, those are the ones we pay most attention to. Let's see, career. I spent a lot of time with Enterprise Rent-A-Car. The same friend that talked me into UC Davis said, well, why don't we go interview with Enterprise? So back in 1990, I started as a management trainee. Worked my way up in the Sacramento Valley. I covered territories anywhere from Eureka all the way to Modesto during that time, and worked my way from a management trainee to a group manager. But at Enterprise Rent-A-Car, it's a very big sales culture, a very big management culture. If you're not moving up, you're moving out. So you're always expected to look for promotions. I took a promotion in Chicago, Illinois. We had never really left the state. I was scared to death, or we both were, but turned out Chicago is a beautiful city. We lived in Naperville and truly enjoyed it. Another promotion, I went to Denver as a regional vice president, did many different regions, did that job for 12 years. You know, at the peak, I probably managed 350 employees in 60 locations. But as Enterprise bought to Alamo and National, they changed the structure. And I, at that point, said, you know what, 22 years is enough renting cars. I have enough gray hair on my head at that point. So I took early retirement. Weren't sure what we were going to do, but we had bought a house in Boise, Idaho, a year previously when our son went to college there at Boise State. So we decided to move into that house, and didn't know what to do, but I always liked the real estate. So I got into commercial real estate, and you can see there, sale and lease of office and investment properties. I did that for 7 years. Everything was going great in Boise. I don't have a bad thing to say about Boise, Idaho. It's a wonderful city. My wife had a Pilates studio. I was doing well in commercial real estate, but we really just missed home, missed family. Tried to get them to leave, and they just would not leave. So we made the decision to pack up and come home. I put here, I think we are the only people in the country that actually moved from Boise, Idaho to California. Everybody else is going the other way. So we came here, I didn't have a job, but you know, we were glad to be here. Fortunately for me, I am consider myself a very lucky guy. I met Jennifer Budwig, and based on my commercial real estate experience, I was offered a job as a commercial lender. So, you know, fabulous company, very family oriented. I'm now been moved up to the branch manager and the commercial lender at the Arcata location. So come see us anytime. We're there. Lastly, I wanted to chat a little bit about Rotary. To me, I've worked in, you know, at Enterprise and Colliers, and we've been very involved in charity, United Way, MS, Denver, but those were always solely monetary involvements. We never really were given the time nor the flexibility to get involved. And that's what really interests me of Rotary and all of you. There are so many things going on and so many opportunities to help the community. And I had said that was one of my things that I really wanted to do when coming back here, was to get out into the community. So I'm so glad to be here, and I'm glad to be a part of this. And I'm looking for, you know, now the next step is looking for ways to get out into the community. So thank you very much. I appreciate the time, and I look forward to one day when COVID is over, meeting all of you in person.
Wonderful, thank you. That was great, and applause. We're so glad to have you in our club, and definitely, and welcome home. Yes, welcome home. I think now is the time I would normally present you with your blue badge. I think you finished all of your requirements. Is that correct?
I did.
Yes. And I was so busy. I can't say putting together my costume, but I was so busy waiting, putting together the auction items for today, that I did not get your blue badge. So demerit for me.
But there's always next week.
I am thankful that there is next week. So we will have your blue badge presentation. Something that that I want to make sure Tomas is here for. So we will do that.